Very good afternoon to all of you.
Good afternoon.
So once again, welcome from Mrs. Raina Khatri Tandon. I am a breakthrough coach. I am also a limitless enabler. I work in areas of training, coaching and mentoring. I stay at Kandivali and I also cater to people in terms of training them, coaching them in terms of sexual harassment and stress management. In case there are any other needs in terms of relationship expert, also I go ahead and mentor few people. If there's any need, you can always reach out to me. Today we are here for a very interesting topic: how to nurture our relationship. We've heard about relationships, we've heard about people, we've heard about parenting, we've heard about anxiety, we've heard about depression, we've heard about different healing forms. But when we have a relationship, how do we nurture? Nurture it is nourish it, right? So we all have relationships?
Yeah.
Yes, we all have relationships. So instead of, it's very well said in a saying, instead of pouring water, if we look at this diagram, it says stop watering the weeds, but start watering so much that it flowers. So a relationship is also like this. In your life, if you start watering little by little, ideally you are not watering the seeds to weed away. You are watering them to flower. That's what you want, right? You want them to flower. You want them to bloom. And why is that two hands? Can you not do it? Sorry?
Protection.
Protection. But there are two hands. Can we not do it with one? Why? Yes, it's kind of, whenever we do certain things, we need two hands. So when we are in a relationship, we are in a relationship with two people, ideally. Now you tell me with whom you can have relationships. So with who all can you have relationship? Whom can you have relationship with?
Relationship that they have with both living things as well as non-living things.
Okay, wow, this is a new aspect, living and non-living. Okay, but with non-living, they are not aware that you are having a relationship with them.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have a relationship with the wife, you have a relationship with the house.
True. So actually, you are attached to them and you have a relationship to them also. So there is a very strong word relationship even with non-living things. Absolutely right. We are attached to them. We relate to them. We look at our toys and we relate our childhood memories. We look at our watch and we relate that, oh, this is gifted by my mom or my dad, and we're having a relationship. We look at our spectacles and then we remember, oh, now I have gone old, so you know I have a grandson, so I play with him. So lots of things are related. And if we say living things, kis 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 saath hamara relation hota hai?
And that living will be plant life, animal.
Very
life,
good.
As well as person.
So we have pets, we have animals. We have human beings. So in humans we have who? Mummy, papa, mom, dad, brother, sister.
The whole world.
The whole world, society. So we have so many people.
And take plants also.
Yeah, plants. Plants, animals, pets. What else? What else?
And there is very important relationship.
Yes, spiritual relationship. I am still looking for one answer. What else?
And self also.
And self also. Very good. So you have relationship with you.
Yes.
Hello, I saw him. So we have also a relationship with ourselves. So apart from having relationship with non-living things, we also have relationship with living things. We also have relationship with pets, humans, plants. Society, we have relationship at work. We forgot about the work. We have relationship with spiritual world and we have relationship with ourselves. Okay? A very important aspect is, if we have to see we have relationship with ourselves, we also have to remember each relationship nurtures its strength, how it says, or its weakness in it. So when we have a relationship, we might have a positive aspect to it and a negative aspect to it. Sometimes we nurture the wrong relationship also. So relationships can't be only positive, sometimes we have a negative aspect to it. But you need to give yourself this permission of being happy. And that can happen only when you have a good relationship with you. And all your relationships, my friends, are going to be connected with the relationship with you. If you are calm, if you are peaceful, if you are complacent, if you are patient, other relationships also will flower. If you are agitated, the other relationships will also get acted like that. Have you seen somebody get up in the morning and he's irritated from the morning, the whole day he's irritated? Yeah? It very clearly shows, and then we blame ourself. Or we blame God. Aaj ka din hi kharab hai. It's not aaj ka din hi kharab hai. It's because of our relationship with ourselves. We are very much frustrated about things. The minute we get up, because not because we've got out from the wrong side of the bed, which some people say, or we've not got up and we've like turned right or turned left, which is not ideally true, but because we did not take a moment with ourselves and say, thank you God, we appreciated Him, we were grateful to Him that we could breathe even one more day. True? We were not appreciative. We did not get up with a smile. We did not get up with that positivity. We did not take some time out to even say, okay, I need to be connected with spiritual world, or I need to take some time out, sit in the balcony, or I just need to meditate, or I just need to do yoga, or I just need to walk. Did not take out that time with myself. Right? It's important to nurture even that aspect. It's okay to be alone, it's okay to be with people, but still you're nurturing that aspect of you. Now what is nurturing? Nurture kya hota hai? What is nurture?
Evolve.
Yeah, evolve. What other words can you think of? We said relationship, we know with whom. Now we need to know what is nurture.
Nurturing is encouraging
your
growth.
Very good. Evolve, encouraging growth. This is the more easier way. Okay. So there is something which is there with you. You want it to grow. Okay. So whether it's a plant or whether it's your own self, only when you water it well will it grow. And this, what goes in, also has to be positive. Right? If you put in the wrong seed, you will get out the wrong plant. So, jo bhi nurture ka meaning hota hai, you are trying to encourage the opportunity or encourage the growth. Even when we say we are nurturing our relationship with ourselves, agar aap andar anger, gussa, hatred, if you are not even appreciative of somebody else's growth, then you are actually stammering your own growth. If somebody else is growing, you can only bless him. Because ultimately you are blessing yourself. That good, I need to just move on. And that's good that that person is growing. Achha hai ki wo achha kar raha hai. Kyunki aap us work apne liye achha hi bo rahe ho. So you nourishing, you encouraging growth, you encouraging opportunities, you evolving. You growing out, you exploring, you emerging, all these are the words which will help you. Each relationship has to have only its positive edge. Be one who nurtures and builds. Be one who understands and has a forgiving heart. Be one who can be trusted. Be one who cannot be fearful. Be one who's patient. These would be the qualities you would need to nurture. Because this plant which is going to come out, or this person which is here, has to grow beautifully, not dry. Okay? If you put in the wrong seeds, you will get out the wrong plant. Okay? So, for you to have this plant growing and encourage its growth, the nurturing or the nourishing should be good. Is that true? And one who looks for the best people, leave the best and the better in the world. Okay? So leave people better than you found them. when we have found you, only when you nourish them, then they will come back to you. You are trying to find out how you can make your relationship better. When you want people to come to you, you will only give them goodness. When they get negativity from you, they will not come to you. That's ideal. There are certain situations where people don't want to come. That's okay. They have been blessed and you can leave them. Eventually, if they have to evolve, they will evolve. Maybe individually and not with you. They have a journey with somebody else. But coming back to the aspect, when we said give yourself the permission to be happy, what is nurturing would be the next question. You said evolving. How do we do it? We need to have trust. We need to have faith. We need to be fearless. We need to be positive. We need to be patient. What else can you think of? How would you nurture this relationship? Because it's very easy to tell that, okay, you have a mother, you have a father, you have a workplace, you have a person, you can scream at him. But can you be patient with him? Can you be fearless with your boss? Can you get up and say if something wrong is happening? Can you have faith in somebody when they are quiet, that they might be doing the right thing? Only then that relationship is having a bond. Yeah, so giving compliments is because of two things. Either you are appreciative, or you need to be grateful or gratitude. If you don't have both of these, then there will be miser compliments. Something is not right in your system. So again, jo beej aap bo rahe ho, the plant which we saw, which is nurturing, you need to have an inner child which is going to be nurtured. So I have found some few things for you. We know this wheel of life. You remember wheel of life? You have different aspects which you will cover. Your career, your health, what are the other things? Your spiritual asset, your social asset, your work asset, and your passion, your family. There can be many. Whatever aspects you take care. If we have so many different things in your wheel of life, to balance your wheel of life, there has to be a lot of nurturing in the relationship. Because you have so many relationships. To think about each relationship, why is it working and how do I nurture it? What is that I can do to nurture it? I should know that there are different fields. There will still be a money field or a finance field. So my relationship with money also has to be positive. If I see people growing and they have more money, I can't say he has done something wrong and that's why he is not getting this money. It will not come to me. If there is somebody going in a Mercedes, I say, oh, I should also have something in that way. Yes, you will have. But to say, oh, he should not have because I am not having, is not right. Uske paas kyun hai? Sabke paas hona chahiye. Ideally, that should be the blessing which comes out. I know it sounds little philosophical, but if you try being that, you are at least trying to be appreciative and grateful in your life, which is going to bring in a lot of patience and trust. Because you are seeing the positive side of the coin rather than looking at the negative aspect. Okay? There could be other things. You need to be here. Have you heard this statement? Can you be here heard? Can you listen to me? You need to hear people and you also need to listen to people. Right? When you are hearing people, what happens? There is some connection. There is some bonding. There is some association. But if you are speaking, it's not going to form any association. So this word nurture is a lot more than just pouring that water. It is giving a lot of effort. Whether you are in a workplace or whether you are in your personal life, everybody wants to be heard. Everybody wants to be listened. Everybody wants to have that inner child being blessed. Everybody has this inner child, right? छोटा बच्चा है ना अंदर. Inner child is your inner voice, which always keeps telling you, I want to do this, no matter you tell him, don't do this. You will have certain passion, certain interest, which will always tell you, yeah, I want to cycle. When I was young, I used to cycle. I want to go back to that. I want to badminton. I want to dance. I want to sing. I want to be with people. I want to go for a walk. All the good things. Inner child will not tell you to do bad things. But there's a negative aspect of ourself also, which we won't call inner child, because children are always happy and free flowing. So we don't call it inner child. We call it our bad voice or our negative voice. Okay? So inner child always has to be awake for you to nurture your relationship. When you are giving so much effort into it, there's also some time. Right? Spending time, laughter, games. Do not under-promise something and do something else. If you promise something, do it. I will call back in 2 minutes and you don't call back. Then people feel that they are not being respected. People don't feel that this relationship is important. Nowadays you put SMSs. You put WhatsApp messages. Give in that time and effort for your relationship. It's important to work. It's important to give credibility to work. But there has to be a time when you have festivities to give time to your relationships. So giving time, having laughter, games, togetherness are different words. Don't attack. Attack who? Attack who?
Both opposite and said both are in opposite.
Don't attack the person, but attack the problem. Don't attack the person. Whenever you have an issue, you have to attack the problem. Always remember, attack the problem, not the person. In that, what happens is you are only talking about the problem. You are not attacking the person. And then your relationship is not getting hammered all the time. Right? The other very important aspect is validation. People always ask, make judgments or validations. These are through experiences which many people come up and tell me, ma'am, why is that everybody wants me to do exactly what they are saying? Why is this validation needed? Why is that exactly my family member is expecting me to do this? Why can't I just be myself? If you have to nurture that relationship, whether it's a youth and a parent relationship, or whether you have to nurture a relationship between a husband and a wife, or between the father-in-law and the son, there has to be a bond. That bond is broken if you don't have trust, if you don't have patience, if you get into judgment and validation. Why? When that question why comes in, you don't judge him like you're interrogating. You have to judge him like he is doing something with a purpose. A purpose has to be defined. If you get into the validation mode or the judgmental mode, then you are somewhere trying to test his truthfulness. That honesty is broken. So there is no nurturing talent. Is that right? You agree with that? Then sometimes people use this, I would call, very important dagger. Stay silent. Every time you don't need to talk. When you want to nurture your relationship, sometimes even being silent is keeping safe, because you don't want to hammer your relationship for something
wrong. Silence speaks louder than
words. Absolutely. Sometimes the silence tells it all. I don't have an answer, but the silence is telling me yes or no. You have to just understand. But most people don't wait for that silence. They get more agitated with the silence. Chup kyu baithe ho? Chup kyu baithe ho? Is not an answer, but for you to understand that relationship, that is how it's supposed to flower. It's keeping both of us safe for a while, till we get some time to process and come back to it. We don't need to address the problem at the same time. We can address it in a little while. True? We can come back to it in a little while. So most important, staying silent, and please, after staying silent, don't jump to conclusion. Great. He was quiet, so it meant this. He's not said it. You making a perception. Please do not jump into a conclusion, because a wrong conclusion can break your relationship. A wrong conclusion of a boss not replying doesn't say that you are fired. A wrong conclusion of a mother not saying yes for a toy does not mean that you are being thrown out. A wrong conclusion of a parent saying no for something does not mean he doesn't love you. It all means that there are different things which they have proposed for your life which is good for you. We need to see the other part of the coin. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Yes. So now that we have seen what is, who is the person who we are living with and we need to nurture, what is nurture and nurturing, now we will see why we are not able to have it. Okay, is this okay so far? Okay, you can do this. Okay, so now tell me, why is it most of the time when we have any relationship we have conflicts? So do we apologize? Yes or no? Yes. Is an apology saying that you are weak? Is an apology saying that you are weak?
No.
No. But then most of the time we find it so difficult. Most of the time we find it so difficult.
It is only a courageous man who can own his faults.
So it is very, 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 very boldly and very beautifully said, an apology doesn't mean that you are the weak. An apology just says that you are giving more importance to the relationship and less importance to your ego. A good relationship, if has to be nurtured, will have at least somebody apologizing, no matter he is right or wrong. That does not mean he is weak or wrong. It just means that for him, this is more important rather than their ego. And why we do not have beautiful relationships? Now we are seeing the why. Because we don't know what is important, we don't know what is prioritized, we don't know how to channelize, we don't know who is important at that time, we don't know why are we doing certain things, we don't even know what is our goals. Why are we running every day in the morning? We are always running behind and chasing certain things. Whether it's money, whether it's job, whether it's train, whether it's people. And why do we need it? Even not for a relationship. We want to develop a relationship, but that's not the way. Do we know what we want to do in life? Most of us don't know. Most of us don't know, right? Yeah, that's why we are laughing. That's why we are smiling. That's why we are laughing. We don't know what we want to do. We don't know what is important. We don't know how to manage time. We don't know how to manage resources. We don't know how to prioritize. We don't know how to channelize our energy. We don't know what is good for us. So when we don't know so many things, then how can we nurture the relationship with anybody? Is it not a beautiful thought? When we don't know so many things, how are we going to nurture it? Many people come and say, in fact there was somebody who just came up and said, you know, I don't know what is the reason I am not getting married. I am 32 today and I want to get married. I don't know why I am not getting married. Everybody else is married around me. So funny. So I said, why do you want to get married? Why do you want to get married? Because the people who are married also are not happy. So you are happy single. He said, no, because people who are around me are happy. Yeah, they seem happy. They seem happy too. So my parents think that I will be happy if I am married. So I said, what do you want? I don't know. Most lucky person, according to yours. But coming to the point, it's very important to understand that what is the relationship with you? Are you really wanting to get married? Do you really want it? If you want it, then why? And when you get it, then why grip? Then face it. So it's very important to understand in running this race to know exactly what you want. To know exactly what you plan. To prioritize, to analyze, to write down, to discipline your mind, to do one thing at a time. That why is important. Which relationship am I going to give importance? What time, where, when, which day? If it's Janmashtami, I have to be at home or not. If it's Eid, should I be working or not? If it is New Year, where should I be? What is my priority? Is it money? Is it work? Is it family? Is it kids? Is it work friends? Is it my pet? Is it my plants? Is it my health? Which is the least priority we give? Ideally, we have to get up in the morning and walk, and we've not done it, we push it away and go for a walk. Until the end of night, it's not been done. And we keep pushing it every day. And then when our health knocks, then our relationship with health bonds. And everything else is left off. Because that becomes priority. Right? So having known what is nurturing, whom you want to do and why, now we will see how. We know the problem. Now we need to find a solution. So are you ready for the solution? We have different aspects of our life. We know that there are different things. We know we have to be appreciative. We know we have to communicate. We know we have to be clear. We know we have to have precision. To have our relationship with other things, whether it's our work, whether it's our time, whether it's prioritizing, whether we developing what exactly we want to do with our life. That one thing which people call niche area, that one thing which I like to do, the one thing which I want to do, our love or our family, our work, our aspirations, our passion, what is that one thing first? And what is the order of priority? When we know what is important, then we can bond the relationship much more easier because we give our relationship that priority. Right? Now we are going to see the last thing. Okay. So coming to this, now we'll see how. So how are we going to do? But before that, tell me, when we are saying sorry, many people say, you know, I go through this word called depression in relationships. And I really want to speak 1 minute before we go to the how. 10% of USA, everybody is depressed. Yeah, so people don't even know, first of all, whether they are depressed or they are feeling depressed. Whether you are actually depressed or you're just feeling depressed. So for example, if I get up in the morning and it's a gloomy rainy day and I don't feel like doing anything, I say, oh, I'm depressed. Because I don't feel like doing anything and I feel lazy. And they say, oh, life is so depressing. So that's not depressing. I can feel depressed for no reason. I can feel depressed for a moment. Now I am feeling depressed. Tomorrow my friend is walking and saying, come, let's go for an ice cream. My depression is gone. So sometimes people don't know whether it's just whether it is just depression or they are really feeling the depression or is it not depression at all. There's a lot of difference between that. So this word, if depression is there and if it exists for a very long time about a topic, then it becomes clinical depression, which is basically a very serious issue, which needs to be taken care. But depression ideally goes only with two things, either meditation or therapy. Can be any form of therapy and many forms of therapy, but people don't even know whether they only have depression or they are only feeling depression. They create their own stories behind depression, but they don't have any depression. Or they create scenarios just basically blaming each other and fooling each other and saying, I'm depressed. So I will ideally say that first try and understand the word depression. Depression is a very big term which says the state of mind when it is very disturbed and it is not able to focus on something and it's doing something else. Then you feel depressed. It's not focused. Ideally, it's a very subtle term, but yes, if you have persisting conditions of it, then it becomes clinical depression, which needs to be taken care of. But in relationships, there's nothing like depression if you can really handle it clean, clear, precise. So it's very important to understand that depression is a very easy word to say, but most of them don't even know the meaning of it, or they don't even feel it. Okay, so let's not use that word anywhere now. And coming back to how. So we saw why, now we are saying how. How do we nurture this relationship? So do you have any answers on how? How do we develop our lovely relationships?
By giving more, expecting less.
Very good. Giving more, expecting less. Yes, what else? Okay, that's the best thing. Don't take, don't give.
No, give but don't give.
Okay, I follow some three L's. Listen, learn, let go. Simple. You won't find this funda anywhere. Just listen, learn something, maybe apply something, maybe give away something, and let go. The faster you let go, the easier your relationship is. Is it true? Very difficult to do, but yeah. Whenever you let go, your relationship will come back. Whenever you let go. It's easy said than done. Sometimes we are in difficult situations, we can't let go, we can't forgive. We have to be forgiving, we have to be accepting. Accepting, forgiving, taking ownership of things, taking accountability of things, understanding people, all these are big terminologies. Ideally, we need to practice them and bring them into our system. It can only be through practice. Nobody can help you learn this, even though there can be millions of people who tell you, come to my session, I'll teach you how to focus. Unless you are not planning to focus yourself, it will not occur. Yeah.
You don't forget the incident, but how do you explain this?
No, I'm not telling you to forget. I didn't say forgive and forget. I said let go. Let go is just pushing it away for some time. When you push it away, you start focusing on something else. And when you're focused in something else, for example, there is a fight in your family and all what you can't do is revert back. So I'm telling you not to revert back, not to respond back, but to let go and push it off and do something else. Ideally, if you listen to music, or if you go for a walk, or if you start talking to your friend, or if you get on a call, or if you open your laptop and start working, the situation is avoided and your relationship is in a better position to be talkable at that moment. It's difficult to not react that time. You will react. If I say don't react and respond, I'm trying to be too realistic. In today's world, being humans, we are tending to get angry, we tend to get frustrated, we tend to lose our temper, we tend to foil our relationship. But I'm just telling you to let go at that moment. Avoid it, let go. Once it is let go, because the first 3 minutes is very critical when you're angry. It can go on and on and on. The conflict becomes very futile. For you to stop that futility and go to the aggrieved position, I'm telling you to come down to the essence of it. Let it not be the 20% anger. Let it come down to a level of say 10-12%, which is easier to handle on either sides. Is that good? Somewhere it will help. Apart from that, kind, constant, trusted behavior. I will put down certain points which is through experience. Maybe it will help. And of course, these are things which have been tried and tested, and they have helped people all over the time during coaching and mentoring. It will help you. Kind, constant, trusted efforts or communication is very important. When you are kind, when you are trusted, when you are constantly talking to that person, he will surely listen to you. If you are not kind, at least if you are trusted, at least there is some form of belief in your understanding that yes, maybe he is doing something to make me understand. I am not saying completely, because we can be individuals with two different decisions, two different talks, but at least if you trust that it can be to a solution, the communication happens. Now, communication word itself is come, you and I make a kit. So, it's communicate, it's come, you and I will make a kit. So, it's coming together. That's communicate, communication. So, we are trying to bring in people. When you bring in people, there is communication. Because of that, there is a relationship bond. If you don't have communication, there won't be a bond. There's no trust. There's no constant mingling of people and their ideas. Next, willingness to hear, willingness to work, willingness to, if you have any challenges, any difficulties, coming together to understand them. Okay, face challenges and difficulties. As opportunities. So, I might have a different opinion and maybe my son has a different opinion. So, if it's a difficult situation, for example, he wants to go for a trip and I say, no, ideally I don't think you're too young for it. So, when you are doing that, he may not listen to you. But maybe you can find another opportunity and tell him, look, if you're not going for that trip, maybe we can go together for a family trip. Maybe along the same side. It could be more exciting. So, you're turning the challenge or the difficulty into an opportunity for something else. It's kind of bonding another relationship, maybe not one, but many. Because in that, the family goes. So, there could be a father-son relationship, there could be a grandfather-father relationship, there could be a mother-son relationship, there could be bringing together friends. You can take her friends and go along. So, what happens is you are getting even the sibling or the friendship also nurturing. Is that okay? So, willingness, then story showing. Whatever you do, always, we tend to go into this story showing mode where we are sharing our new experiences, past experiences. For example, if something's not happening and your child or you are having difficult customers, the customer is not able to understand your viewpoint and you are telling them this is going to work and you rather try it. You can always tell them, oh, in the past we had this kind of a customer and he went ahead and did this and there were some losses. So, when you do that in a very story showing way, he's thinking about what's happening or what could have happened. And that can help him to analyze the situation and give you better perception to it. So, he might think about, yes, maybe she's coming to a right perception, I need to at least explore. Story showing always helps you to share past or new experiences. Always think to step out of the box. When there are certain things not working in a relationship, to nurture a relationship, you always need to think of something different. If A is not working, B is not working, you need to go to C. So, there are either A and if B is saying something else, you need to find the middle path with a C. A will talk this, B will talk this. You have to find a middle path. That's where a relation can nurture. If you constantly say, no, I am right, and he says constantly says, I am right, there is nobody right, nobody wrong. You'll only end up in not having a good relationship. You have to find the middle way. Okay? Emotional support. Of course, you need to have emotional support on all sides to have a nurturing relationship. This can be support in terms of friends. Sometimes it's also about having fun moments together. You can have fun, you can have engagement, you can have games. Sometimes you can have humor. Sometimes you can go out together. Sometimes you can connect. Sometimes it's about distractions from your daily course. Monday to Friday are always working. Everybody is working. Children going to school. Everybody is busy. Your workers are always busy. Sometimes it's just taking all your workers back to a trip or a picnic. It's trying and adding humor, fun, games, learnings, but with an element of smile. Okay? So, smile, humor, games, fun. trying to add this into relationships will make it more nurturing. It's going to bring in the serenity in you, add the essence of that. Then I follow the CAFE. Can you guess what is CAFE? Compassion, empathy, compassion, acceptance, feeling, empathy. These are again big words, but if you have a lot of love for people, you will forget about the differences. N number of feelings of compassion, being able to empathize how the people are feeling in cases of being, when I am fighting, how does my child feel? When he is fighting, how is the scenario of the house? When they are fighting, then what happens? The entire office is getting disturbed. So that kind of feeling will obviously bring in some kind of compassion for the others and an acceptance that I can have feelings which will eventually forgive and maybe forget. I'm not saying will, but I'm saying may be forget. But you will at least forgive, because you will want peace, harmony and a great relationship with that person if you want to hold him back. If the relationship is more important than the ego. True? If the relationship is better than the ego. And last but not the least, let us accept everybody's mistakes, add, share goals, dreams, passion, talk about it to each other every day. When we talk about each other, we talk about our challenges. When we talk about the challenges, we talk about our differences. When we talk about the differences, we are talking about the difficulties. And then we are able to understand that everybody has different difficulties. But when we don't talk, we are not sharing goals, we are not sharing dreams, we are not talking passion, we are not talking about how we can take it to each other's level, we are not talking about our aspirations, we are not talking about what success we want to reach. How is that other person is going to understand your differences, your difficulties, your passion towards reaching your success? He will only be bothered about his relationship with you. Okay, so let's nurture this relationship today. There is one small activity which I want you to do. You are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are two people needed and one person will try and put it in between. So maybe three of you can come in front. And you can try doing that. That's just trying to make the relationship closer between you today. So it's a paper activity which has to be done between two beautiful people to bring the relationship together. I will request three of you to come here, and within a stipulated time, if you can do that, that would be great. Okay? So, yes, can I request somebody to come? Covered. I'll just finish the talk and the slide. If there's anything you have, you can always ask. Shooting. Okay, so did you guys enjoy the activity?
Yes.
Was the bonding exercise useful?
Yes.
I think mostly it is the essence of the nurturing relationship is always about giving time to your loved ones, whether it's at workplace or in personal or professional life. It's important to take the right time out for the right person and to give the right effort at the right place. So I wish you all the best. Tomorrow is a very auspicious occasion of Janmashtami. I wish each one of you and your family members, lovely viewers at Help Talk, a wonderful Janmashtami and a great, great successful journey with your nurturing relationship. Thank you so much, and this is from Raina. Thanks.